coming back at you. Before I get started, I wanted to apologize. I did a video yesterday. For some reason, YouTube said I violated some codes or somebody's patent rights or whatever. I don't know what the hell I did. But anyway, and I posted on some pages. I went back and I deleted them and, you know, apologized for that. I don't know. Tell you the truth, if I knew what I did, I'd correct it, but I don't know what I did. So we're going to try this video here. It's going to be video number 3 on the 124 record. The video here will be on the boom deck assembly. Show you a little bit of where I'm at. Show you some things I'm trying and what we did on this. And hopefully you'll enjoy it. I seen this same record built. I can't think of the guy, gentleman's name. Outstanding job. I mean, he did an outstanding job. And my hat goes off to him. He's on one of the truck pages. And anyway, so we'll go ahead and get started here. Move this down here a little bit. We'll start with the, I started my boom assembly. Some of the stuff we did on here, I wanted to add chrome. If you see a chrome here, on both sides. And what I did, I took some dress pins and I put them in all the holes. I had to drill out the holes. This is an old, boom assembly that I'm working with. If you look and you see the little holes there, this one's the same way. I drilled them in, I added those, and picture up above shows you the step I took. And then what I did is I just went and cut them all. I've started with this, added my lights to it on here. Added my lights for the sides up there that go on there. On these here, we started with those. Then we got there we go. That's the only bad thing. You guys know I usually use a switch box. But anyway, this stuff's being put together until I get it all done. Then I'll run it to my switch box. We'll go from there. On this turret, on the boom assembly, I'm trying something different. That's the joy of building kits. I'm going to take and make this where I can control it. In other words, add a small motor and control my boom. I can move it or whatever. What I've done, I took me a small motor, okay, and I put together a board, okay. Board takes, let me move this down here so I can show y'all. The board takes a battery pack, and it has three lights. Push button, change the thing. You got three settings. One setting on the left is to control it manually when you turn it. Then you got your neutral setting. Then you got your setting number 3 with it automatically constant rotation of the motor. What you do is Okay. If you see there, that is, bring it down here so I can show you working the board. That is constant rotation. Okay. On one light. It just goes back and forth. Okay. Then you go to the next one, which is neutral. Then you go to that third one. Okay. That's where I'm controlling it. Okay. And my plan is that I will take and you take and run your shaft up through here, up underneath your chassis of your kit. Then your boom will sit on there. Now, you know, it's not going to stick that high up. And the thing is once I fasten it, go back to our board, okay, and this is how it works, okay. Then you go to the next switch, neutral. Then you go to the other switch, which is constant, okay. That's what you have, okay. And all the parts are not put on there, not glued down, because I'm still working on it. But anyway, that is my game plan, and we'll go from there. Now, on your frame of your record, the way I plan on doing it is, this is an old frame that I'm starting to work on here with for a crane assembly to start my frame. But anyway, if you look, you got between your rails, your frame, you got the cross members. Your motor has two notches on each end. All we do is take the notches and put it in there like that, okay? As you can see, you don't see it on the bottom. Once you put your tires, you have enough clearance, and we'll fasten it, and then your shaft will come up once you put your deck and everything on there, and you won't even see it. And if all works right, I'll show y'all, it'll turn out. The board, okay, got three lights, and it's like I was showing you, got a small button here, neutral, constant rotation, and manual rotation. Made this little board. It didn't take me, took me no time to make it up, really. Got me the schematics and just put it together. So now, on the boom assembly, I'm sorry, the deck assembly, we'll go ahead and show you how I'm coming along on that. Lower the camera here, move it back so you guys can see it all. We've got our stuff all in place. What we did is we added some LED lights in here, down the sides, in the rear, down the sides, and then out here we added caution lights on each side. When we did that, what we did is we did a parallel wiring schematic. And just to show you what I'm talking about here, if you look at your wire, your lights, they're constantly to the next light. We did a parallel. We go from negative to positive, negative to positive, positive, negative, blah, so on. And that's how we did that. On our area back here, let me show y'all here right quick. Usually I got all this hooked up and I can just turn on my switches, but I haven't got, as you can see, haven't got it all wired up to my box. Once I do, then all I would do is hit the switch. As you can see here, on both sides, we have our caution lights. I added them in there on the boom arms. So you could, a little bit of something to add to it. On our side lights here, as you can see, we've hooked up all of our lights. Blinking lights down the side, it's red and white. And we've added them to our tail end and everything. That's on the far the side. And then we've done the same thing on the other side, which and done the same way. Once we get done, then what we would do is all these wires go underneath there. The reason we got to do two switches like this, once I hook it up into my my switch boxes, got these many lights. It takes more voltage because the lights require so much voltage on it. And that's the reason. One of the other things we're going to try is once I put that on there, the motor, we'll put it up underneath there and you probably won't see it. You know, it's trial and error. This is my first time, but I wanted to try something different. And I thought, well, I mean, I'm not doing nothing else. I might as well hook up a motor and see how it goes and see how it works. And then we'll, once we put it all together, the reason I haven't glued that to the boom is because I got to run it up underneath the chassis of the frame of the truck, fasten it there first, and then put all this on top of it. And then I'll glue the shaft in. The shaft, you could probably make it out of different. I use styrene. You can make it out of brass or whatever. But anyway, we've got our other stuff moving along. We're getting our nitty gritty for our boom assembly. So we should hopefully get it all done. The kit's a good little kit. I've enjoyed it. Like I said, I've seen it built by a couple. Turned out really nice. So with that being said, wanted to just do a quick video, nothing spectacular, let y'all show where we're at. Hopefully this video will go through. But again, thank you for subscribing. And if you want, leave comments. People have commented on them, and I appreciate all the comments. Some are good. Some are, you know, they say how they feel and all that stuff. So go ahead and comment. Tell me how you feel. And hit that like button, and I appreciate all the subscribers. We'll be having another video out, and you get on that subscribe list, and you get a notification every time I post a new video. Well, that's about it. Y'all be safe. Keep modeling, and thanks for watching. We'll talk at you later.